built all the Cuban ball, life on the moon, with Harry Long and John. Monday and Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, Harry Long and John. The satellite's gone, way up to the sky. Things like the drag me out of my mind. Oh, I watched it for a little while. I loved you all things on Zoo TV.
One of the things about rock and roll stars is they're bigger than life, they're bigger than the audience, they're almost intimidating. Well, this whole set is like that, right?
That's right, yeah.
Isn't that off-putting? Doesn't that kill intimacy, though?
It does, yeah, absolutely, but you look great.
Zoo TV, this thing, what is it?
There are many, many levels to Zoo TV.
This is the lowest. This is...
You know, last time we saw you, you were a normal guy. You know, you wore normal clothes and stuff. Now you got the suits, you got the fly boots, you got the, the fly goggles. I think that's a dye job on your hair. What's going on?
You didn't like me when I was me, so I found somebody new.
You're not hiding something behind those shades.
And you love him. Old Blue Eyes is back.
We kind of found that when we got back, we were going to be hanging around for a few months, and we thought, well, why not get into the studio? We had a great kind of momentum of what we'd been doing, and we'd had a great year, and it was, let's just put some tracks together and maybe, you know, have some new songs for the a new show in Europe.
I guess most bands would have probably taken the time off, relaxed, tried to recover from the tour. But I think working on songs, being in the studio, is a sort of therapy in a way. When you come off a tour as mind-blowing as the Zoo TV tour, peace and quiet is the last thing you want. We're hoping that we'll at least get 3 or 4 of the new songs into the set. And with any luck, the album, or whatever it is, EP, mini album, will be out sometime in the summer, probably late June, early July. At this point in time, it's hard to know exactly what it will comprise of. You know, we've got, as I say, about a dozen ideas, but we probably won't finish them all, so we'll just see. Well, I don't know really whether it's there will be an obvious connection. I think it's like the next dispatch, you know, from the front. It's just work in progress. I hope it's just signs of creative life, you know, from the band, and we just wanted to get back into the studio because there's a lot of energy and a lot of good ideas floating around from the tour. So it was almost really something that we wanted to do rather than something we had to do. And I mean, I think there will be, it'll sound probably like a logical extension to Acting Baby, but I don't think anyone's thinking about it in that way. It's just, you know, the next batch of songs.
Zoo TV can kind of be anything you want it to be, and last year we kind of discovered all the things that it could be. I think now we can kind of, we can go back to it with more ideas and more material because we have the songs together, and we can make it the audio-visual experience we always wanted it to be.
I don't think there'd be any way that we could go out and repeat the Zoo tour on the Zoo Roper tour. Just, it wouldn't work. So at the minute we're sort of working on some new ideas, going into different countries, using different languages, different texts on the screens, and it's a major challenge, and I'm looking forward to it.
I think Europe is much more geared up for the future in a way than America was before this election. I think Europe is generally looking forward to the turn of the century. I think Europe is a little bit more cynical about the grip of the media upon it. So I think these are two things that are going to be, these two ideas of the turn of the century and the media as such and what you believe and what's truthful and what's relevant to your life and how much of it's under your own control. I think these are issues that are going to be valid in Europe over the next 10 years. I think the unification of Europe is going to present as many problems as it solves. And I think people are aware of that. I don't think they're particularly idealistic about it. So I think what we're going to be trying to do is touch on those issues and not necessarily preach to anyone, but certainly in our own way, within the context of the Zoo TV tour, is perhaps have our own particular unity, the United Colors of Zooropa or whatever. I think it'll be a ray of sunshine in a very bleak year. It's going to be the stereo MCs for most of the tour. There's a couple of shows they can't do. And then we're kind of juggling around with a number of other bands that we haven't really confirmed yet, so I'll have to do a voiceover at a later date.
Using words, using text in art pieces is nothing new. In fact, really, with the whole thing about Zoo TV, everything we have is existing technology, apart from the Trabants, which have ceased to exist. But everything we have is existing technology, and it's really the application of it more than anything else. You know, the fact that it's ours now and we can do what we want with it. And the thing about using words and using text, it's not that it's a new idea, because advertising has used it all the time, but it's just putting it in a new context gives us an awful lot of power. And the thing I love, the real thing I love about the opening of the show is for a band who, for years and years and years, the show was just about them. There were no tricks, there was nothing clever, there was nothing fancy going on. It was just about the four people on stage. The first 10 minutes of this show, it's actually impossible to look at the band because the sensory overload is so high.